All right, let's talk a little bit now about Thanksgiving specifically. What it means to the city, and we've kind of touched on it a little bit, but looking back, Thanksgiving game to Detroit, you know, a couple of years ago, the NFL tried taking it away from the Lions.
Sure.
You think the Lions deserve to keep it here, and why, if they do?
I simplest answer is tradition. It really is. I mean, the NFL, you know, they have this monocle of, you know, protecting the shield. The shield's what is important out there. Well, around that is also tradition. And holding traditions, I think, is pretty sacred. You know, if you look at colleges, they have traditions that they have. I think the NFL needs to keep the tradition that they started with having the Detroit Lions be a part of Thanksgiving Day game.
I agree.
Yeah. No, he's right. I mean, you know, that's all I remember about the Detroit Lions before I got here, before I became part of the organization, was they played on Thanksgiving Day game. That's what I remember. So, and I remember the Silverdome. So, you know, to me, like Eddie said, it's a tradition. It's a tradition that's been here for a long time, and it's a tradition that should stay here in Detroit.
Yeah, I'll piggyback on both of you guys and say that I think this city is probably the city that appreciates that game the most, and they deserve it. And the players always show up to play that game. It didn't matter how bad we were. We always showed up to play that game. And you always remember, you always can take back growing up seeing the guy dressed as a pilgrim. He's still doing that at Ford Field today. I mean, I remember watching him out here.
I actually applied for that job.
Oh, you did. I mean, you still see that. So, yeah, that's
a good point. Yep. Yeah.
All right. Favorite Thanksgiving Day memory for you, Dom? It doesn't have to be a Silverdome. I know we're sitting here, but we're talking Lions. This is about football week in Michigan, about Thanksgiving.
Well, it started here, my first Thanksgiving day. And to talk about the noise, I say the electricity of Thanksgiving. And it's a game like no other. I mean, you only have 3-4 days to prepare for it. Yep. The game was always here. It'll always be here. And then the most positive memory is beating Brett Favre on Thanksgiving. I mean, he beat the brakes off of him. When Dre Bly, you know, had the Goblin Gobbler Award, whatever. I still remember, you know, a lot of these things like yesterday. But, yeah, that's, you know, the game started here. And my first year, my first Thanksgiving here, well, I'll never forget.
Yeah. For me, it was, again, the 91 season. They wanted me to say something about Mike. It was a tribute that we gave to Mike right before the game. And I remember, because they came to me and asked me to do it, and I really didn't. I told them no at first because, you know, I try to get myself all psyched up for the game, and I knew reading that it would take my emotions down because it was such an emotional message that we were going to send Mike. But in the end, I was happy that I did it. I did it. It was great. We won that game, and it just kept pushing us forward. So that's mine.
No, yours a little bit different, Ed.
It's a lot
it's
different.
Memorable,
it is memorable, and it goes back to rookie year. My rookie year in 1980, the Thanksgiving Day game, we played against Chicago, and we went into overtime. And I kicked the ball off, and they returned it for a touchdown. So it's the shortest game.
You should have kicked it out of the end zone.
Well, you know, back then they used to kick him high into the goal line. And I forget his first name. I remember his last name was Williams. He returned it down, you know, I always remember me trying to catch him. And all it was focusing on me. I was like, I was the only guy on the field. The way the camera view went, because we just surged over to the left side of the field, and he went and returned it to the opposite side. And I'm the only guy in the whole frame trying to chase this Olympic sprinter.
No, you were very athletic for a kicker, and I saw you play racquetball, and you were very quick.
Yeah.
You were not top-end fast. So
I was not. No, from here to 10 yards, I'm great. But then after that, the piano jumps on my back. Yeah.
I think my favorite Thanksgiving was, I think it was 83, my second year, we beat the Steelers 45-3. And the Steelers were still the Steelers, so to speak. Yeah. They were kind of waning from their dynasty in the 70s, but they were still solid. And we just opened up a can on them. And it was just, and I headed up north after game. Keith Durney, Big Cheese, went with me. We headed up for 3 days at my place up north. So I always remember that. You know, people always say that Lions, you know, they're just so good on Thanksgiving. If you look at the record, we really have been that good. But the fact that people have this image, and we've kind of fostered that image of having success, it just shows Lion fans, they hang on to the really good moments, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we just hopefully we'll get a few more in the future. On Thanksgiving, you got to remember now, people scheduled their Thanksgiving dinner around you, what we did. Yeah. How did you ever think about that as a player, that everyone is waiting to eat or trying to eat before the Lions game so they could watch you?
We used to think about it because Wayne used to bring it up. He was real good at, kind of letting us know the significance of Thanksgiving game. He was a really good coach at doing that. He always used to tell us we were the first game on TV. The whole nation was watching. This is an important game. You get to put your stamp out there. Yes. So he would reiterate that every year and I played in 11 of them, and he was consistent with it each and every year.
Yeah, it was definitely unique because you knew everybody was watching that game.
Yeah.
And, you know, it wasn't hard for me to realize that everybody planned their day around it, because growing up in Hawaii,
right,
the game started at 7 a.m.
Right.
Yeah. So I was watching them at 7 a.m. and my day started with, you know, with breakfast. You know, mom usually made breakfast, and, you know, I was like, couldn't, you know, locked into the Lions games, always at 7, either on Fox or CBS. And so it wasn't hard for me to notice, you know, to notice that that day is planned around football, and that meal is planned around football.
Yeah.
Well, I just grew up in UP. Thanksgiving, we go snowmobiling before the game. It was so cold, but yeah, always. You know, my family are huge Lion fans growing up.
Newberry.
And my mom. A lot of times we're fast eaters. Have you ever been around me now?
Yes.
You know, we hang out in the winter a lot.
Yes.
I mow it pretty quick, so I think I've gotten that. Sometimes we try to, like, eat at halftime. Two parents, six kids, get back to the game. So, yeah, it was a great tradition, and it did affect our families, and it's going to affect families in the future as well. Well, you know, guys, this has been great. Love getting back together with you. Yeah, Dom, you're looking good. Thanks. Dom's daughter's killing it in volleyball. Yeah,
she is.
Last night. Lom, you're off to see your son?
DNA. Yeah.
Aren't you heading out right after this?
Yeah, going to see my son play his last game of the year. So we're excited about that.
And, you know, Ed, you were just saying, Rob, your son moved to Vancouver.
Yeah, my
son's
a
Canadian.
Well, I'm American now. I became an American citizen 4 months ago. So
lucky you are, because you might be getting deported.
Very proud of doing that. So, no more A's in my speaking. But my son, who lives in Vancouver, is excited to move back to my hometown, Victoria. So he's all excited about the move to be closer to some relatives.
Outstanding. Well, guys, enjoy your Thanksgiving. Have a great holiday. And enjoy football week in Michigan.
Yeah.
Fox Sports Detroit.
Yeah.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.